So this thing's been growing in popularity lately, and I feel we need to talk about it. It's called HTMX, and it's a tiny framework, if you could call it a framework, that allows you to send Ajax requests without writing JavaScript. The server response has to be pure HTML, which is then injected into the page. Now, why am I talking about this? Like, I feel like I'm watching someone about to jump in a pool filled with sharks, and I need to warn them, stop, what you're doing is wrong. You're going to get yourself eaten alive. Now, let's start with the pros of HTMX. It's really easy to learn. You barely need to know any HTML at all, and no JavaScript. And basically, that's it. That's the entire list of pros I could think of. Now, let's go over the list of cons and why you should avoid using HTMX for anything other than hobby projects. It breaks down separation of concerns. So instead of receiving pure data from your server, you're getting it wrapped in HTML. That HTML also has various area labels and extra JavaScript, event listeners like onClick, onLoad, etc. That HTML also has styling, HTML5 elements like video and audio, and a canvas and some SVG and some images and some table elements, etc., etc. So what's wrong with breaking separation of concerns, you might ask? Well, if you want to do anything non-trivial with your server response, you first need to parse it with JavaScript. So you're out of HTMX instantly. You first need to remove the CSS, remove the extra images, remove the extra table elements, remove the extra canvas, video, audio, and image elements, remove the inline styling, remove the event listeners, remove anything and everything except the text. And what you're left with is just pure text. You still need to parse that into an object. Good luck with internationalization and localization issues. It's going to be a horrible mess to do anything above the simple HTML replacement thing that HTMX does for you. Secondly, it destroys your user experience. So every time someone clicks on a button, they now have to wait for the entire HTML response to be loaded from the server. Not just, you know, status colon true. No, it has to be this huge HTML with styling and images and all that stuff. And it's all sent over HTTP. What about edge cases? In fact, these are very common issues like double clicking, triple clicking, event bubbling, and so on. Well, the short answer is bad luck. It's much more expensive to run than a simple open API, for example. So look, the user interface is for user interface things, and the backend is for backend things. If you're mixing the two, you're going to get bad side effects, and one of them is having to shuttle huge chunks of HTML back and forth. You cannot cache those responses either because they have to be complete HTML by design. That's what HTMX requires of you. So you can forget about progressive web applications. It's as if that entire web stack doesn't exist anymore. So what's the difference between a 20 bytes response and a 20 kilobytes response with every single click? Dollar bills. That's the difference. Apart from the extra bandwidth requirements and poorer user experience, you're going to find it extremely difficult to reason with an app that mixes styling, layout, which is HTML, data, and interactivity in its API responses. This is all just a discussion around developer experience versus user experience at the end of the day. DevX versus UX. I would argue that most modern tech stacks are verbose. They do have a little bit of a learning curve. So you need to know your JavaScript, your TypeScript, and you need to go through a few tutorials to get started. But that's fine, because once you do, and you learn to use available tooling, your developer experience dramatically improves. The point, though, is not to sacrifice user experience ever. Even if available tooling was indeed really difficult to learn, you would still need to never ever sacrifice UX over DevX, because your end user is your customer, and they pay for the whole thing. You should really never sacrifice UX, especially for short-lived, early days developer experience when you're just starting out. Yes, it's much faster to start an HTMX project than a React project. But medium to long term, your developer experience as a React developer or any other modern tech stack is orders of magnitude better than using no framework at all, or worse, HTMX. The user experience, on the other hand, never recovers with HTMX. This is a fact. The UX actually gets worse in time with HTMX as your project grows. Look, you'll find out the hard way that no matter how much time you spend on the thing, considering all edge cases and trying to optimize it, you're always going to bump into the lack of separation of concerns problem, poor scalability, and really, really bad, horrible user experience with unjustifiable bandwidth requirements. HTMX is a Stone Age tool. It's seductive in its simplicity, but we're building modern web applications on modern hardware using modern tech stacks that become exponentially more lovable as you climb that learning curve. Trust me, we don't need to get back to the 1980-something, unless it's the Goldbergs. And we don't need yet another memberberries pie. Just do yourself a favor, learn JavaScript or TypeScript, go through that React documentation, and thank yourself in 6 months. So this is it. This is my entire rant for today. Separation of concerns matters, bandwidth matters, and user experience trumps developer experience, no matter what framework or tech stack you're using. So if you want to keep on enjoying rants like this one, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.